Hey, Brett McFall here, and in this lesson, I want to teach you how to get that section that I call the journey right. Like, how do you actually think about it? How do you create the content in the right way? What is the best way to actually get this done? If you get the journey section correct, it does a number of things, but I'll give you some of the highlights of what it does for your audience. Because remember, psychologically, we are leading them to become our students, right? To begin our program. And so what this section does is it has to give. It really has to give massive value. Now, I don't mean just jam the content out there so people are going, oh, I'm overwhelmed. No. It has to give value. And giving value, awesome value, means making things simple to understand so people can actually use what you teach. It's not about quantity, it's all about quality. And so in this section, you're going to show them how you teach, because how you teach them here is how they suspect that you'll teach them when they join your program. So you do a lovely job here, then they understand, okay, well, I feel comfortable about getting more training from this person or company. So it's about laying things out nice and simply. It's about clear, concise messaging and examples and creating a story to help people understand it, okay? And so I'm gonna go to my computer here in a second and take you through how to think about it, how to do this for yourself, how to fix up the middle part of your presentation, which is called the journey, and make sure that it's singing, right? So that people are going, wow, I'm loving this. They're taking notes, they're liking you, they're getting excited and can't wait to try out what you're teaching them. That's the sort of effect you want to have, and as a matter of fact, the sort of effect you have to have if you want sales at the end of your presentation. Give, so that if nobody buys, they still walk away with awesome value. You've created goodwill. But of course, what I know is, once you put all this system together and put them through the opportunity section, then that is when it results in massive sales, okay? So let's go to my computer right now and I will teach you more about doing the journey section for your presentation. Let's go. All right, moving on to now that next step, journey. The journey you're going to take someone on. So the question to ask is, what is the journey that you want to take people on? People love going on journeys. We all love journeys. We love adventures. So, let me give you some examples. What is the journey you want to take people on? Is it steps to achieving a result? And you know your product or service better than I do, so you can answer this, right? Steps to achieving a result? Are there steps? Then lay out the steps. Teach people the exact step, just like I'm doing for you right now. There's three steps here: message, journey, opportunity. I'm outlining the steps. Just do these steps and you'll be much better, right? Other options would be problems that are in their way. The journey you want to take could be based around the problems that they're going to face, the problems and challenges that they're going to face. Because people often like to tune into the negatives of the world. It's more alarming, it's more dramatic if you tell them about the problems they're going to face to achieve a certain goal. Or are you the new information made simple person? The journey is you make new information much simpler. Maybe you're the simplifier. You get into your presentation, your goal is to make XYZ subject made much simpler than anybody else has ever made it for them, so they truly understand it. Or is it this one, a process that no one else uses? Which camp are you in? Which one of these four are you in? And there are other camps as well, but I'm just using four for this presentation. A process that no one else uses, a secret herbs and recipes, herbs and spices recipe rather, like KFC does. What is the secret process? And of course, I'm actually doing, in this presentation, I'm doing two. I'm doing steps to achieve a result, but also a process that no one else uses, my message, journey, opportunity, my boomerang blueprint. So I'm actually hitting two in one. Here's some tips. Teach three things only, but really teach them. Don't just gloss over them. Don't just say, here's the step. So I hope you got that. Now let's go to the next step. No, really teach, which often means telling stories or giving steps, as in giving examples rather, or showing pictures, showing before and after results, showing case studies. These sorts of things make it so that learning the three things is exciting, it's fun, it's educational. But just three things, no more than three. Unless you're exceptional at what you do, exceptional. But most people, just three things is all they can accept when you're in an audience. You've only got space in your mind for three things at that time. But really teach them. Really teach them. Don't back out anybody. Really teach it well. Another tip: make the journey so simple an 8-year-old can understand it.
So always think that your audience is around about 8 years old. Now, that's not being disrespectful. In fact, it's being respectful, overly respectful, which means we leave nobody behind. Your presentation probably will not be seen by eight-year-olds, but when you're creating it and when you're delivering it, your goal is to make it so that an eight-year-old can understand. And that's what I'm doing for you right now, keeping everything very, very simple, trying to give you stories or examples or ways of looking at things that you can easily understand so I don't lose anyone along the way. You know, people will never get offended if you make things simple, but they certainly will get offended and they will leave and they will tune out if you make it too hard. Often what I find is a presenter makes something so hard and it makes themselves look good. Right? They're trying to make themselves look smart to the audience. No, that's all about you. It's not about them. Make it so simple an eight-year-old can understand. Another tip, give everything, hold back nothing. I'm of the school that the more you give, the more you receive. And I've lived this now since 2002. Changed everything I was doing in my life to, instead of holding back until I was paid, I gave everything and then got paid even more. So I give everything. Even this right now, I'm trying to give you every single thing I can in the time I have here. Hold back nothing. Hold absolutely nothing back. Give everything, and that becomes refreshing. I'm not saying overwhelm somebody. I'm just simply saying don't hold back. Give everything you can. Give the full story. Give the right steps. Tell them this tip, that tip. Help them out so they have to do nothing in order to be able to benefit from what you're teaching. This is the difference. This is what gives people authenticity on stage and gives the audience a great feeling and a great energy. Because they can feel it. You're not tricking anyone if you're holding back. They can see right through it. Another tip, always say which means. So anytime you explain a step or a problem or new information or a process, always add these two words on the end of it, which means. The reason why I say that is that when you use which means at the end of anything you're teaching, it forces you to think of the benefits, which means you'll teach what people really want to hear, the benefits, okay, which means it forces you to say the benefit of what you've just taught them. Okay, so for example, you know, there are three steps to my boomerang blueprint, message, journey, opportunity, which means it will fit into any presentation that you have. It'll make everything nice and simple, just follow the formula, which means you'll be able to make a good connection with any audience, which means you'll be able to make more sales. Now, do you see what I just did there? By using which means, I was able to just highlight the benefits that really stand out to you. And it's very powerful, very powerful. The goal through the journey section is to show the audience the possibilities and break down the walls between where they are now and where they want to be. I'm going to say that again. The goal of the journey is to show the audience the possibilities of what they could do. Paint the picture of where they could be, what they could be achieving. And then break down the walls between where they are now and where they want to be, because they see a barrier. They see themselves where they are right now in their current situation, and they know there's a better future if they were to learn some more stuff, otherwise it wouldn't be listening to you. Your goal is to break down those walls so they can see a clear line, a straight path to where they want to go. So suddenly they feel, wow, I actually feel I can do this. I think I could go there. I think I could do that. Cool, right? I mean, I'm just talking common sense here when you think about it, but very few people actually do this in their presentation.